Okay, let's turn now to consider social causes. And here the question has been framed by historians as, was the French Revolution caused by class war? This is a theory that goes all the way back to Karl Marx in the 1840s. And again, we need to ask the question of why France? Let's begin by comparing French society to the society of its nearest powerful neighbors, Great Britain and Prussia. And here I'm going to return to that issue about whether the revolution was an accident of history or was French society in crisis on the eve of 1789. And I'm going to show you in this first part how little characterized pre-revolutionary France that was not also true of the other major countries of Western Europe. So, on a scale from most capitalist to most feudal, France, as you will see, ranks somewhere in the middle. So Britain was definitely trending closest to in a capitalist direction. By 1789, Great Britain, British society, was free of all traces of serfdom and feudalism. All the land was freely owned and exchanged on the open market. That means anyone could buy, anyone could sell. The nobility did exist, but they didn't enjoy any meaningful legal privileges. By and large, they operated in a world of rights. And the middle classes in Britain were growing rapidly in numbers, in wealth, and in self-confidence. And some of them were actually able to take part in government by winning elections to the House of Commons in Parliament. Now, Prussia, on the other hand, was still extremely feudal, still very stuck in a more or less medieval outlook. The nobility owned most of the land, and the peasants owned hardly any. The nobility also dominated their serfs, and they controlled and occupied all important positions in the army and bureaucracy, and they had many significant legal privileges. There was a middle class, but it was tiny, and it was politically weak. So serfdom and feudalism are still fully intact in the Prussian system. Now, France has remnants of a feudal system, but they are also starting to move in a capitalist direction. So they have a lot of serfs. Between 150,000 and 1 million of the peasants in France were still enthralled to serfdom. So that's between about 1 and 5% of a population of 20 million. And most peasants, whether serfs or free, owed dues to the noble landlords, which they paid either in kind, in fees, or in labor. 40% of the land was owned by the nobility or the church, but the peasants actually own 50% of the land. So half of the country is owned by what were called the little people, the menu peuple. The nobility did enjoy certain legal privileges, but not so many in Prussia. So they did dominate most high positions in the church, army, and in the government, but not all of them. There was that nobility of the robe, which was coming into power, moving up from the middle classes. Other privileges enjoyed by the nobility was exemption from major taxes. They had the right to carry a sword. And one of the most peculiar rights they enjoyed was the right to death by decapitation, by having their head cut off, rather than death by hanging, if a nobleman or woman happened to be convicted of a capital crime. But if you look at the bottom of the chart on France, you will see that the middle classes are growing. They're not as large as that in Britain, but they did triple in numbers in the 18th century. So to sum up, France is a hybrid of capitalist and feudal systems. It was not totally free of its feudal past, but it was also not totally stuck in it.